Hello, my name is Mordred Viking, and I'd like to welcome you to this very special episode of Mord's Reports. Now, Mord's Reports actually dates back to when I was actively developing Prophecy of Pendor 3, when basically they were a series of bug reports that I would submit to the team depending on the current build. In that, I could find any issues that were arising, bugs and errors, obviously. I thought I would do something similar for YouTube, though it won't be obviously bug hunting, at least I hope not, but rather more of a state of affairs for the channel itself. So it's an opportunity to talk directly to you guys, the commenters, the fans, the supporters, that's the best word really, of this channel, and basically give you a rundown of how I think things are going, what things are likely to change, upcoming series, things like that, new features, you know, the usual kind of thing. And generally just a chance to engage with you guys, so anything I say here, then please do absolutely feel free to add anything in the comments. So if you have anything that you want to say about how the channel is going, do let me know there. Now, the very first thing which I want to say is this is the 100th episode. That's mind-boggling. 100 episodes already. That's fantastic. I did not think we'd be reaching this so quickly, although thinking about it, having been going for month and a half, 2 months or so, two episodes a day, more or less. Yeah, so channel's been going really well. I'm really happy with that. The channel has grown up to 241 subscribers. I mean, my gosh, that is completely mind-boggling to me. 241 subscribers already for 2 months' work. I mean, that is insane. I'm really pleased that so many of you've chosen to support what we're doing here and to like follow along with it. I know that different groups of you will come from the different videos. That was part of the intention. The games that I play are quite varied. I mean, they're mostly strategy in some way. But, you know, I do different things. Plus, of course, I have the unique insights into Pendor because of my work as a developer there, which I'm sure has added me a couple of people. But I hope you're actually enjoying how the game itself is being played with the Klaus and the Mettenheim style. So, at the moment, we have got several episodes which have come out. So we started out with the Europa Universalis IV custom nation of Stormwind, which unfortunately had to stop because of a corrupted save game. Then shortly after that, we started working on the Prophecy of Pendor Mettenheim style, which has been hugely, hugely popular. That's really blown up way more than I could ever have imagined. I mean, quite honestly, at this stage, I was expecting to have maybe 20 people watching, if that. We have a lot more than that now, which is fantastic, really. So thank you so much. I just want to keep on saying that. Very recently, we've also started the 24 custom casters, which is playing from Brancaster. It's a map that I've basically set up with 24 custom nations and 8 hordes. So I hope that'll change things up a bit for the usually E4. So the world's more balanced, you won't expect to see the same kind of powers rising and etc. And that should be pretty cool. The other big announcement I have in terms of a new series, which will be coming very soon, like probably an hour or two after this video comes live, is I'm going to be playing XCOM 2. That has just come out. It's going to be, well, it is fantastic. I've spent most of the day playing that. And yeah, it's as good as all of the rave reviews have been saying. I'm really super excited about that. I have been streaming that today for 2 hours or so, just getting through the two tutorial levels and the level after, in which I didn't do particularly well, so I'm pleased there's no real record of that. However, I have started a new game of XCOM, and that's the one I'll be doing for the YouTube series. I mostly wanted to do the games I did today streamed, just so I could learn the game a little. And I think I've done that, though there's definitely way more surprises just waiting down the line. I can't wait to see those, and I really hope you'll join me for that. It's, yeah, XCOM's good. It's really good. I was actually planning to do this Mord's Reports in front of a camera, so you could see my highly smiley, happy face. Unfortunately, I was playing XCOM, so that didn't happen in the end. So instead, you get this little clip of me playing Attila Total War. Speaking of Attila and speaking of streaming, the other thing I want to do is start a regular Sunday stream. That will be at 3 p.m. GMT every Sunday. So 3 p.m. GMT is what, 10 a.m. Eastern and some ungodly hour Pacific. Sorry about that. But it should be going on for a couple of hours, probably two or three at the minimum. My plan there is to play a variety of different games. It'll mostly depend on what I'm in the mood for at the time. The main one I want to start playing is Attila Total War Age of Charlemagne. It's a new expansion that came out a month ago, less than a month, 2 weeks, something like that. And it's all about the late Dark Ages as opposed to the early Dark Ages, so like Rome's Fall and that kind of thing. It's basically the prequel to Medieval Total War. So Medieval Total War starts in 1066, I think. This starts in 7-something. It's like the very beginning of the Viking Age. So you might have a guess who I'll be playing as and why I'm so interested in this. Hints in my name, people. And in fact, I'm playing this battle right now. This is just regular Attila as the Jutes, who are a Viking faction. So I'll be playing as the Vikings. Going to guess the Danes. I think they're the only playable. I haven't actually booted it up yet, so I couldn't tell for sure. But I'm very excited about that. I really rate Attila very, very highly. Definitely more so than I did Rome 2. Yeah, so that would be very, very cool. What else did I want to mention? Ah, yes. I also have been doing a multiplayer game of Minecraft with a couple of my friends. I did want to do that as kind of a semi-regular stream, but it's just not worked out. I had all kinds of problems with the streaming software. It's just, it hasn't worked. So hopefully I'll be able to do like little updates. I'll introduce you to my various friends and the various projects they're doing. We're basically building a massive kind of city with each building with different things inside it. Like there's a factory, there's the magic area. It's with a mod pack, which is Rising Resonance, I think, 3. Yeah, I think that's the one it is. I haven't been able to play that as much as I would have liked because I've had so many other games to play. It's actually a great time of year to play games, which is obviously awesome because gaming is cool. Ah yes, the other thing I might be doing, possibly, hopefully, which would be really nice, is a multiplayer EU4 game in the future. A couple of my friends and I have been playing that on a semi-regular basis, and I've said I really want to start recording this because it's a lot of fun, and I think you'll kind of enjoy the way that we backstab each other, or like in the last session, we actually were really, really supportive. And we kind of needed that, because I would have been wiped off the map. I was playing as Brandenburg, and my cousin was playing as Venice, and he would have lost probably about 3/4 of his empire. So we don't usually collaborate to that extent, but we're allies, so we kind of needed to. I think that's all I have to say. Please do let me know if you have any suggestions or things that I should change on the channel. Seriously, I'm very, very much open to hearing about that. Likewise, please do like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this, though it's only a kind of state of affairs thing. And thank you so much for your continued support in keeping this channel running, because really, it's what keeps it going, is like the input that you guys have and like the talks that we can have in the comments and stuff. So that's awesome. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.